Hello student, class 9. Today I'll explain and solve chapter lines and angles and exercise 6.1. But before starting this exercise, you have to know some terms and definition related with this chapter. First one is line. A line with a straightness which extends indefinitely in both the directions and cannot be drawn wholly on a paper. So it is endless. Now the second one, line segment. A part or portion of a line with two end points is called a line segment. Now the third one, ray. A part of a line with one end point is called a ray. Now collinear points. If three or more points lie on the same line are called collinear points. Otherwise, it is called non-collinear points. Now, reflex angle. An angle which measures more than 180 degree but less than 360 degree is called reflex angle. Linear pair of angles. When the sum of two adjacent angle is 180 degree, then they are called linear pair of angles. Now student, you have to know also axioms, postulate and theorem. What is axiom, what is postulate and what is theorem? So axiom means assumption and postulate means which is taken to be true without proof. Now lastly, theorem means true by accepted mathematical operation. Theorem proved that if two lines intersect each other, comma, then the vertically opposite angles are equal. So diagram also given. This is the diagram. These are the two A, B and C, D. These are the two ray. Now start. Let A, B and C, D be two lines intersecting each other at O. The two pairs of vertically opposite angles are formed, such as number one, angle AOC and angle BOD. Then number two, AOD and angle BOC. To prove that angle AOC equal to angle BOD and angle AOD equal to angle BOC. Now proof, ray OA stands on line CD. Ray OA stands on line CD. Then therefore, angle AOC plus angle AOD equal to 180 degree. This is equation number 1 and in bracket linear pair axioms. Because sum of these two angle equal to 180 degree. This is the first axiom of this chapter. So it is, that is why it is 180 degree. The sum of these two angle equal to 180 degree. Now again write, ray OD stands on line AB. Ray OD stands on line AB. So again, there also two angles are formed. This is one angle, this is another angle. So here also write, therefore angle AOD plus angle BOD equal to 180 degree. This is equation number 2. In bracket all, same thing you write, linear pair axioms. Now comparing equation 1 and 2, we get, this is first you write in left side, then give equal, and then write this one. Because 180 is equal, no need to write. So these two, that value and that value, you write here. Now here you see AOD, angle AOD. Here also in right side also angle AOD, in left side also angle AOD, both are same. So you can cut these two. Now what remain? Angle AOC equal to angle BOD. Similarly, it can be proved that angle AOD equal to BOC. We prove here angle AOC, this angle is equal to angle BOD, this angle, vertically opposite angle. These two are vertically opposite angle. Now similarly you can prove that this angle AOD is equal to BOC. So hence proof. Now exercise 6.1, question number 1. In figure, lines AB and CD intersect at O, full stop. If angle AOC plus angle BOE equal to 70 degree and angle BOD equal to 40 degree, full stop, find एंगल BOE एंड रिफ्लेक्स एंगल COE. सो दिस इज द डायग्राम. यू विल ड्रॉ अगेन दिस डायग्राम इन योर एक्सरसाइज एंड देन राइट सॉल्यूशन. लाइन्स AB एंड CD इंटरसेक्ट एट O. लाइन्स AB एंड CD इंटरसेक्ट एट O. Therefore, angle AOC, this is the angle AOC is equal to angle BOD. This is another angle. These two angles are equal and these are vertically opposite angle. These two are vertically opposite angle. But given that BOD, angle BOD equal to 40 degree, it is given in question. So angle BOD equal to 40 degree. So write it and give equation number 1. Therefore, automatically angle AOC also 40 degree. Why? Because already we showed here angle AOC is equal to angle BOD. So automatically angle AOC also 40 degree. Now again write angle AOC plus angle BOE equal to 70 degree. It is also given. It is also given. You can write here given also or without writing also you can do. Now angle BOE equal to 70 and minus, this will be minus when it will go on right side. So minus angle AOC and that value you know it is 40 degree. So 70 minus 40, ultimately it is 30 degree. This is Roman 2. Now reflex angle. Another one you have to find out reflex angle, angle COE. Now write reflex angle, angle COE equal to COD plus angle BOE plus angle BOD. These are the three angles, COD, the straight angle, then BOE, BOE, this angle, and BOD. These are the three angles, right, in the, and give plus sign, plus sign. Now, put the value of COD, this straight angle, you know, 180 degree. This is, you have got already 30 degree, and this is also got 40 degree. Now, add all this, you will get 250 degree, and this is, you've got that value from equation 1 and 2. This is right inside the bracket. Now it is the answer because reflex angle cannot be cross 360 degree. It will be less than 360 degree because we know reflex angle is more than 180 degree but less than 360 degree. So this is this much this. Number 3. In figure, angle PQR equal to PRQ. Then probe that angle PQS equal to angle PRT. So again you will draw the diagram. That diagram will be given in your question also. If you see in exercise or sorry, if you see in a textbook, you will get this diagram. All the diagrams are given. Again you will draw this diagram when you do the answer. So solution write first. Then ray QP stands on line ST. QP, this is a ray, stands on line ST. This is a line. ST is the line. Then therefore PQS, this angle, the exterior angle plus angle PQR, this angle, interior angle. Thus, the sum of these two angles equal to, you know, 180 degree. And this is equation number 1. So inside bracket write linear pair axioms. Then same way you have to write ray RP stands on line ST, RP. Stands on line ST. Therefore, PRT, this is outside angle, that is exterior angle, plus PRQ, interior angle. So sum of these two equal to, we know, 180 degree. This is equation number 2. So inside bracket, write linear pair axioms. Now from 1 and 2 we get, this is 180, this is 180. You have got already such type of equation. So these two are cancelled. So this will be remain, that will be remain. So write in both left hand side and right hand side. And again you see in your question, angle PQR is equal to PRQ is given because these two are equal already said. So these two no need to write PQR and PRQ. These two are equal. So you can cut these two. So ultimately that two will be remain. That two is what? PQS equal to PRT. Hence proof. Figure POQ is a line. Full stop. Ray OR is perpendicular to line PQ. Full stop. OS is another ray lying between rays OP and OR. Prove that एंगल ROS इक्वल टू हाफ इन ब्रैकेट एंगल QOS माइनस एंगल POS. नाउ सॉल्यूशन, ड्रॉ द डायग्राम अगेन इन योर एक्सरसाइज एंड देन स्टार्ट. सिंस OR इज परपेंडिकुलर ऑन PQ, दिस इज गिवेन यू, दिस थिंग इज गिवेन यू. OR इज परपेंडिकुलर ऑन PQ, OR इज परपेंडिकुलर ऑन PQ. Therefore, if this is perpendicular, then we can write angle POR, POR, this angle, equal to QOR, this angle. Because this is a perpendicular, it is straight, so each angle is 90 degree. So, in bracket write, each angle is 90 degree. Implies, now you can part it, because POR, is there is two angle. So, you can write in part way. So, POS plus angle ROS, OP and OR, prove that angle ROS equal to half in bracket angle QOS minus angle POS. Now solution, draw the diagram again in your exercise and then start. Since OR is perpendicular on PQ, this is given you, this thing is given you, OR is perpendicular on PQ, OR is perpendicular on PQ. Therefore, if this is perpendicular, then we can write angle POR, POR, this angle, equal to QOR, this angle. Because this is a perpendicular, it is straight, so each angle is 90 degree. So, in bracket write, each angle is 90 degree. Implies, POR, you can part it two. POS, POS and ROS. These are the two angle. Of from the POR you can write it. Then QOR there is no part, so you take maximum angle. So this is the maximum angle QOS, big angle. Now you can part it two. How? QOS minus, you do same thing, but there is no part of angle, so you take big angle QOS. From QS, QOS minus ROS, when you part it, you'll ultimately you'll get what? QOR. So this is, you have to think it how I did. QOS minus ROS. Then ultimately what remain? QOR is remain. That one is remain. So now you make it same way, right? Angle ROS. Here also R angle ROS there. So write these two together and then you write equal to give. And then write angle QOS and then take angle POS on right side. Now add these two, you'll get twice angle ROS and this will be same. Now ultimately you'll write implies angle ROS equal to half in bracket write angle QOS minus angle POS. Now hence proof. This much today. Thank you. I think you understood whatever I explained. Now please subscribe YouTube channel to get more update to my video. Thank you.